Welcome to Pilates at noon. Today we are going to start in virtual. But what you're going to need for the class is a ring, a ball, or a towel, a strap, and a mat. And if you want to do your standing work with shoes on, feel free to do so. It's more supportive to the feet. Once we go to the floor, you're going to need your shoes off. So let's get started with some virgin work. You can use a chair. You can use a countertop, or you can use the wall for balance, or it's really brave, you don't need anything. So let's start in parallel, and let's bring our knee out and tap it down. Knee out, tap it down. Pull from the abs, the low abs, pull the leg up. The body remains strong and active, but not moving. Up, now take it to the side. This side, it stays quiet when you lift the leg. Four, three, two, one. Hold it there. Now bring it to the front. And we're going to press up 8 times with the knees. 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. To the side. Take it to the floor and to the floor to the side. Now two and two. Single. Up. Four, three, two, and one. Good job. Knee down. We're going to do the figure eight. We're going to take our leg up to the tabletop. We're going to bend it out to the side. This, you're going to take a figure eight with your knee, cycle. In, out. Don't drop the knee. Keep it hip height. In, and out. You're getting the benefit of internal and external rotation. Pelvis. Of the rotators in the legs. Four. Three. Two. Pelvis is steady. Trunk is long. Good job. Bring it down. Take it out to the side. Keep your legs parallel. We're going to do hot potato tapping out to the side. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Stand tall. That standing leg is tall and strong. One more. Now bring it here. Now we're going to transfer it into external rotation here. The inner thigh is going to get the workout. Flex the foot. Cross the midline and lift. Then, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Another step. Keep that heel. Knee turned out, hip turned out. One more. Standing leg is strong. Point it and flex it. Point and flex. Point and flex. And point and flex. 4, 3, 2, and 1. Good job. Shake it out. Let's go to the other side. Slow mo first. Everything is in parallel. The legs are right under your hips. You're going to lift and lower. Up, down, up, down. Try to do this whole exercise without moving anything but the leg. Four more. Four, three, two, and one. Slow mo out to the side. This ain't love, it's great to see. But darling, stay with me. Up, up, up. pump it for 8. 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. To the side. 2, 3, 4, 5, 7, 8. Now 4. And 4. Now 2. 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2. Now singles. 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, and 2. Good job. All right, your hands come away. So we're going to pick up the leg, take it out to the side. Pull those abs in. Square the hips. Draw figure 8 horizontally with your knees. In and out. And in and out. 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Good job. Very strengthening to the hips. Back to parallel. Knees forward. Toe points out. Leg long, standing leg strong. Tap it out. Eight, seven, six, five. Hot potato. 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Last set. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Such a tiny movement, and very deep. Now, turning out from the pelvis, the knee is out to the side, the heel is out to the side, in line with the hips. Cross that midline, completely across. Flex the foot and lift. Think up. 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Last set. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Point and flex. Point and flex. Point, flex, point, flex, point, flex, point, you flex, 4, 3, 2, 1, shake it out, good job, okay, so now we're just going to roll our shoulders and put the back, roll our shoulders and put the back, hold, and roll. And then we're going to bring our hands behind, pull our abs in, and lift. Now hold that lift, stretching out the front body, and you'll feel the tightening of the back of your shoulders. Eight, seven, six, three, two, one, turn, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. And one, hold it here. Eight, seven, six, five, four, three, two, and one. You can always sit down, get tired, take a little rest, and go back up. Feel the stretch of the low back and arms, the glutes. Up to sitting position. Then we'll segue into reverse plank. The heels are deep into the floor. You can bend your knees if this helps. Place your hands firmly on the floor, right under your shoulders. Widen your collarbones and take your inhale at the bottom. And then exhale as you lift the hips off the floor into reverse plank. Squeeze your inner thighs, knees, and heels. Feel them working to keep your legs long and to assist your abdominals. Breathe for four, three, two, and then lower down carefully. Shake out those wristlets, roll them in the opposite direction. And then shake them out. Let's do a little bit of C curve work, working our abdominals. Slight bend of the knee, not too deep, arms forward. We're going to sit as tall as we can sit, pulling our abs in. And then we're going to round at the tail. Then, at the pelvis, and get the waist towards the floor into a C-curve, and hold. Hold. Scoop. Breathe. Lower down a little further, this time maybe to the waist, and hold. And work. Two. And one, now down to the shoulder blades, and all the way down to the floor. Good job. Let's bring the arms into a bowl post arm. Bringing the ribs close to each other. The two ribs come in close, knitting close. Wrapping, navel in, pelvic floor lifted, and hold. Now let's practice some breathing. Point your toes. Bring the arms up. Inhale. Exhale. Bring the arms down to bowl pose. Up, down, up, down, up, down, up, down, up, and down. Hold it right there. Take the arms long. And flex the feet. Feel the entire body. Try that again. I'm going to let the music, I think it's a little louder. all the way up, and then all the way down. And this time we're going to go all the way up, and stay up. Squeeze the glutes, let the knees float to the ceiling, wrap the ribs and scoop the belly. Hold it here and tap it down. Lift it up, tap it down. Lift it up, tap it down. Lift it up, down, up. Now I want you to hold it there, engage that entire low body, lower body. The upper body is open and active. And let's just hold that for 30 seconds, using the strength of the glutes, the hips, and the abs to hold you there. For 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Let's go for 8 more. 8, 7, 6. High hips, strengthen the hips. For 4, 3, 2, 1. Tap it down. This time we're going to go up and we're going to walk it out and then walk it back. Keep the hips high and out and back and out. You'll feel those hamstrings fire up here. Try not to wobble when you walk, and back. And change legs, lead with the left. 1, 2, 3, 4, take it back. 2, 3, 4, and reach, and back. And back, forward, and then back. One more, and forward, and back. And hold, hold it there. Squeeze those glutes. Feel the spine come down one vertebra at a time, using your breath, exhaling, exhaling, back to neutral and rest. Good job. Let's take our rings or balls or our thick towels and let's squeeze our inner thighs. Line up the hips, the knees, and the toes in one track. Make sure the tailbone is on the floor and the pelvis remains neutral while you hold the squeeze. Statically hold it and breathe. And soon you will feel the quiver of the inner thighs if you're doing this correctly. Breathe. For 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Now from here, we're going to roll up. One vertebra at a time while we squeeze our ring and hold. Now we're going to press in. 2, 3, 4. Pulse. 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 5, 6, 7, 8. Hold it there. Tighten it up. All back body work. Roll down. 1, 2, 3, and 4. Release. Good job. Okay, let's finish up our bridging with the suspension bridge. So we're going to take our legs out long first. Flex our feet. Draw our heels in about 2 inches with a slight bend in the knee. The pelvis is neutral. The upper body is active, and we're just going to hover the glutes off the floor. They're not on the floor, just hover them and hold it. You'll feel your whole lower body recruit, fire up, and hold. Pull your abs in for 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Good job. Bring those knees in. And let's just breathe and rotate the pelvis letting all those ligaments, muscles, relax and reverse. Good job. All right. We are ready for our ab series. We're going to take our arms up in 90 degrees, plug our shoulders, glue our hips, knees, and ankles together. Inhale, exhale, roll through to the tips of the shoulder blades and prepare for the 100. Ready. Inhale and exhale. Inhale, exhale. Choose your leg position. Inhale, exhale. Inhale, exhale. In through your nose and then out through your mouth. In and in for five, out for five. In for five, out for five. Last one, and out. And bring it in. And let it go. And this is where you might want to introduce the skinny towel. So when you do this, you want to make sure that it's a skinny towel. Like this. Not a big fat towel, because that won't help you roll up. This will just give your low back the support it needs. Our legs are long, our feet are flexed, our shoulders are down, our ribs are wrapped. We're going to take an inhale to prepare, and then we're going to exhale. Lift our heads, our shoulders, our ribs, our waist, and round over with our neck in neutral alignment with our spine. And then inhale, and we're going to roll back. Two, three, four. Good job. Let's try that again. Inhale, exhale. Scoop the belly, strap on that seat belt around your waist, and make it tight as you inhale and exhale back down. Again, inhale, exhale, and then back. So we're going to do one more. Inhale, exhale. Notice that I do these slowly, so we can really control the movement from our powerhouse and not momentum. And down. All right, let's take that towel from under our back and lift our right leg into the air without moving our pelvis. Slightly turned out from the hip, lengthening through the back of the knee. Upper body is active. Cross the midline. Cross. 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 Two more. And then reverse your circle. Think about painting a circle on the ceiling and down the walls as you let that leg rotate around that hip. Change legs. Cross the midline. And then reverse your circle. One more. Bring it down. Bring the knees in. And take a moment just to stretch out that low back. Hands behind, head up, and roll. For rolling like a ball, come to the edge of your mat. Pull your heels in, squeeze those inner thighs together. That's really important for this exercise. Try to balance off your feet. Elbows broad, shoulders down, focus downward. Take an inhale as you roll back. Exhale as you come up. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Breathe. Really important. It's a breathing exercise. One more. And hold. Prepare for single leg stretch. Roll back. One and two. Three and four. Five. Six. Seven. Eight. Double leg stretch. Tailbone stays on. Knees come towards your chest. Upper body is high. One and around. Lengthen and around. Three, four, five, six, two more, seven, and eight. And right leg into the air. For scissor, you want to help your hands at your legs, help your upper body come up. Eyes at your knees. And one, two, switch. One, two, switch. Try to keep a nice scissor leg. One, two. Nice long scissor leg, I should say. One, two. One, two. One, two. One, two. One, two. And hold. Now, let your neck rest on the floor. Eyes right at the ceiling. Legs up in the air. Only to the point where the tailbone is still on the floor. Neutral pelvis, open the leg and cross three times. Open, exhale. Inhale, exhale. Inhale, exhale. Inhale, exhale. Scoop your belly, don't brace. Widen your chest. Let the breath flow. Hold it here, scoop your belly, take your legs down, and lift them up. Exhale down, inhale up. Keep those legs moving in a short distance if you feel any arching in the spine. You want to make sure that your pelvis remains neutral. Three more, two more, and last one. Bring it in for tabletop, crisscross. Reach out with each leg, opposite arm, opposite leg, rotating through the upper body, quiet through the lower body, except for the legs. For four, and three, and two, and one. Let's take a moment to stretch. Release the rectus abdominis. You can arch the back here. Take an inhale. Take all the tension out of your body. Ready to move on, bring the arms around. Bring the knees in, head up, roll up. Time for spine stretch forward. Sitting tall against your invisible wall. Flex your feet. Let's point our feet. Flex. Point. Flex. Point. Wake those legs up and point. Now flex them and make sure they stay flexed throughout. Arms are forward. Shoulders are down. Inhale. And let's start to peel off that invisible wall, one vertebra at a time as you move forward from the top of the head to the tailbone. Now we're going to go back onto the wall from the tailbone onto the top of the head, slowly through articulation. Inhale. Exhale. Concentrate on the spine, peeling off the wall. One more time. Inhale. Now that we've warmed that spine up, it's time for open leg rocker. Let's open our legs, shoulder height, shoulder width, and bend the knee, bend the knees, and point your toes. Try not to move your legs. Eyes on the horizon to start, shoulders down. Inhale, look down. Exhale as you roll, and then inhale back up. The breath is so important here because it helps the timing of the exercise and activates the core muscles. Legs are long if you choose. Eyes on the horizon. Inhale. Exhale. And hold. Hold it there. Lengthen through the spine at the top. Eyes on the horizon. Bring your legs down. It's time for the corkscrew. Tailbone on, hips in neutral, shoulders wide, arms long, eyes at the ceiling, take it up, circle the hips and legs, and then come back to center. The opposite direction, circle, stop, up to 12, 6, back up to 12, and then back to the center, last one, up, circle, and stop. Good job. Bring it up. Let's do our saw. Flex your feet and open your legs. Most long sits in Pilates require the feet to be flexed. The back of the knees are long to the floor. The sits bones are equal to the floor. Shoulders are down. Chest is high. Arms are out. Now, don't collapse in. It's the tendency here. You want to lift high. Turn. Look behind you. Round over that leg. Come back up. Straighten the spine. Keep the twist. And then center. Turn, twist. Look behind. Round over. Come back up. Tall spine. Keep the twist. Hold. And then center. Turn, reach, up, center, turn, reach, never let the sit bones leave the floor, they're planted there, deep into the mat, reach, up, center, and last one, reach, up, and center. Good job, close your legs. We're going into the opposite direction now, prone with arching or extension of the spine. So let's just settle in. Since we've been doing so much flexion work, let's feel the back settle into extension. Press your hips gently into the floor. Lift your navel off the floor. Try to raise your heart to the ceiling and breathe. Bring your hands to mid-chest, and we're going to practice extending the spine, articulating them. Elbows are in, nose is in the water. We're going to lift our chin, then our neck, then our collarbones, then our heart, and then our sternum, and head back down, sternum, heart, collarbone, neck, nose. So it's an articulation of the front of the body. Inhale. And down. Inhale. And down. One more. Inhale. And down. Good job. All right. Now we're going to incorporate upper body lifts with lower body lifts. They work consecutively with each other. Alternatively, you go up. And then you lift the legs, up, lift the legs, up, lift, up, lift, up, lift, up, lift, and rest. That's the prep for the swan. Arching the body, using the abs, a little cardio. Let's come back down onto our elbows with them broad to the, each side of the mat. Clasp your hands and lift your heart. You'll feel the upper back extension. Your legs should be in line with your hips, not wider. And let's point, flex, point, and lower. Point, flex, point, and lower. Point, flex, point, lower. Point, flex, point, and lower. Two more. Point, flex, point, and point, flex, point.
Good.
Hold it there. Bring the arms around for double leg kicks.
Lace the fingers,
drop the elbows.
Turn the head, lengthen the legs.
To the floor. Then we're going to lift the upper body and feel the stretch of the upper back and chest, and turn and drop the elbows, and three times kick together. Open up that chest, arch, turn, drop the elbows, and kick. Up again, feel the stretch through the chest. And kick. And take a moment to stretch out that low back in the child's pose. This time, let's bring our arms behind us and feel that low back stretch. Feel the glutes stretch. Rest pose. Coming back up into a sideline position. Today we're going to work a little of the inner thighs. Did some outer thigh work standing today. So you have options for this one. You can keep your leg, your top leg right there, or you can cross it over. But make sure that the knee is going towards the ceiling, it's not collapsing. So you can choose that position. If you feel like you want to do one with the leg in the air, this is much harder. You got to keep that rib cage up. Flex the bottom foot and lift. And lift. Turn out some of the pelvis on the low leg. Lifting that leg to come up to the leg in the air. Scooping the belly. Keeping the shoulders down. Balancing and up. Now open it up wide, heels to the front, and lift it this way. A little harder. Lift. Remember, you can do it with the leg down. You don't have to be in the air. There's always an option. Six, seven, eight. Good job. Bring the legs down. So this was kind of a prep for the teaser. So once you're stacked, the arm goes into the air. We're going to roll the hips back as we lift the legs into the air and then back down with control, keeping those shoulders wide and down. Let's try it again. Inhale and exhale and down. Using the deepest abdominals. Inhale. And one more. And back. Good job. All right, let's take a moment and go to the other side. And we're going to repeat those inner thigh leg work either here, here, or here. Always remember, ribs in, chest open, shoulders down. Flex the bottom foot and lift. Two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. Now take it up, open it to the front. Lift. journey deep into the inner thigh. Four, three, two, and one. Good job. Bring it back. Let's stack the shoulders, stack the hips, lift the arm, and roll the hips back on an inhale. Lift the legs on the exhale. And inhale. Major core work here. And down. One more. And rest. Good job. Okay, let's proceed to the supine teasers. And there's no rule that you have to come all the way up. You're still getting a great workout if you come halfway and back down. It's a process, and it's better to do it safely and correctly than to try to come up and force something that your body might not be ready for. So, it's not the destination, it's the journey to the destination. So from here, let's go to the tabletop position, keeping the tailbone on the floor. Squeeze the inner thighs, that will help slide the shoulders down. Now I want you to bring those arms up over your head, but plug those shoulders, okay? Inhale, wrap your ribs, exhale, come up. And then back in. If you come this high, that's perfectly fine. So let's try again. Inhale. Exhale. And back in. One more. Inhale. Exhale. Back in. Now, continue on that path. This will advance the exercise. Arms over the head, but don't let the ribs boink. We're going to come up almost until we pass the low back in the articulation, and then we're going to lift the legs. This is a tricky one, so be very careful. I'd rather have you just halfway and back if you don't completely understand it. So we're going to inhale, we're going to bring the arms around, start to lift the head, start to lift the spine, and then when you get to the waist, you're going to lift it up and then back down. Use your breath, so important. Inhale, exhale. One more of these. Inhale, wrap those ribs, get them ready. You don't want to be completely unhinged at this soft tissue here. You want that powerhouse to be working. Inhale. Exhale. And then bow. And perfect. Now let's just stretch it out. And then from here, let's bring one arm over, then the other arm, and move into prone again for the swim series. So arms are overhead again, now in prone. The legs are long to the floor. You're going to reach up into an upper back arch, lift the thighs off, keep the arms long, and swim. Inhale, and exhale. Inhale, exhale. Inhale, exhale, inhale, exhale. Bring those arms around into breaststroke. Inhale, exhale. Use the core to arch the spine. Use the breath, not momentum. One more. Bring your arms together, right under your shoulders, palms up, shoulders back, and lift. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. One more, and you're going to get a nice stretch. Inhale. Exhale.
hand stretch.
Rest that body.
All the tension is gone. Put your arms out to the side here. Take your breath. Come back up. Place the arms long. Keep the glutes in the air. And now feel that stretch in doggy pose. Or puppy pose. And hold.
So good. Now we're going to go right into the mermaid series where we pull our knees together and raise our arm, drop our shoulder, and a perfect side bend. And not too much forward, not too much back, right over the shoulders. And you'll feel that stretch right through that oblique area, waistline, ribs, hold. Always breathe during your stretches. In through the nose and out through the mouth. Open it up wide, and now you're in the extended mermaid position. And reach over and circle that arm. And then into that side bend where the ribs really, really open up. Drop the shoulder. Breathe into that right lung. And then pull the navel in as you turn and reach that right arm to the diagonal and hold. Don't forget to breathe back into the side bend. Legs come up and over to the other side. The knees are going to go to the right now. And the right arm goes up. And there's that side bend stretch. Feels so good. Drop that shoulder into the joint. Breathe. Open it up. Right into that wide mermaid. And over. Insert. This gives your pelvis a chance to do internal and external rotation on each leg. Healthy hips, drop the shoulder, side bend, breathe into the left lung. And then reach to the diagonal, pull the navel in, square the shoulders and breathe. Back over. And back into a seated position to prepare us for our leg stretches. So during our cool down stretches, it's really important to keep the breath going. It relaxes the body, it brings its body back to its natural state of homeostasis. So don't cheat yourself and not breathe through these exercises. Such a wonderful way to end class. Pull one leg into the ring or the towel, the strap. Slide your shoulder wide, iron the leg to the floor, and lengthen the leg in the air. Feel that stretch through the back of the knee, hamstring, and calf. Breathe in all that oxygen, and let all the carbon dioxide come out. Open. Square up at the hips, square up at the upper body, and breathe. Back up, cross the midline, change hands, and let's get that outer thigh, IT band area. Make sure the breath's not going into the neck. Put it into the diaphragm. Into the lower belly. The neck should have no strain in it. Inhale. Exhale.
breath should be equal. The same amount in, the same amount out. And back up and change legs. Lengthen through the back of that knee. Elbows broad, shoulders down, chest wide. Take it out to the side. Inhale. Exhale. Drop those shoulders away from the ears. Inhale. Cross the midline. Change hands. Flex the foot and feel that stretch. Find a comfortable spot on the floor. We're going to stretch out that upper back and neck and shoulders. So let's lace our fingers behind us. Pick our shoulders up to our ears. Take them back and drop them down. Create space. Hinge from your hip. Try to lengthen through your spine and lift those arms. You'll get your chest stretch and your bicep stretch here. Inhale. Exhale. Back down. Sit tall. Roll your shoulders. And reverse it. Bring one arm out. Bring the other arm down. And raise the heart. Look to your right. And look to your left. Don't move the shoulders. Just the neck and chin and neck. And a wide open chest. And then let's take a moment to do left ear to left shoulder. Pick up that left arm. Make sure your head is not bobbing forward, that it's right in line with your spine. And then you bring the ear to the shoulder. So you feel it stretch through this soft. Keep the shoulder. Lean down, keep the palms up as well. Back up and change sides. You feel it stretch right through from the ear down to the shoulder. Make sure you breathe. Back up, bring the arms up. Elbows back. Back up. Lower the arms. Let's take the same amount of breath in and the same amount of breath out. So let's inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Good job. Hope you enjoyed the class today. Enjoy your week. Stay safe. And I'll be back on Friday at 11 o'clock for cardio fusion and 12 o'clock for Pilates. See you then. Thank you.